Okay, welcome to Railroad Video Number 4, the annual Cast Scenic Special. We're going to go up the mountain again, like we did the past 2 years. And we'll show you how we did it. As we told you before, it used to belong to the Maurer Lumber Company, and there are the ruins of the mill up ahead there. Up here is the locomotive we'll be riding in, number 4.
How to do that. I Thank you.
permit stop at Whittaker Station. We're taking on water up here.
Thank you.
here. Now it's Bald Knob. And this is the train that brought us up here. And as per usual, thought you'd like to look around. This year it's not as windy, so the sound should be a bit better. Sorry about your hi-fi light. Sorry it doesn't stay on. I hear him playing my song. There you have it. Like I keep telling you, year after year, a lot of class at Cass. I've been told there's a story behind engine number 5.
You can't pick it.
I'm gonna try to find it out.
Of course, you had to take all this down to take it in. We had another shaft up last night. Actually, this shaft was made for the middle up here. You see, it has this thing on back here.
Oh, yeah.
Where, like, it's hook on right there. We got done about 10 o'clock last night.
Yes, he's saying he got to stay up till 10 or 11. Yeah. Now, is this a permanent repair, or is this something that you'll have to take and change out?
They'll have to order a new piece of steel, and they'll take that, tear the old one down, take all these collars and gears and stuff all off of it, put it on a new shaft.
Is that solid, or is that collar?
No, it's solid.
Well,
solid
steel. Oh, it has to be. Mom's holding up.
I didn't know, but they said a piece of steel, and I wanted to verify with you.
What we'll do then, go ahead and run it and see how the machine's making the new shaft.
Yeah, I mean, after it's made and everything, how long will it take? It'll take this one off and take all the gears off and get the new one back on.
Well, what I'll do is take the gears off of the other shaft down there. Okay. See, these here gears will stay right on this shaft. Once we get the other shaft all assembled, we'll just roll this one out, take all these nuts and stuff off. Bring this out and uncouple this universal here and roll your other shaft in and put that right back up. Yeah, about 2 hours. Maybe 3.
That's still a lot of work.
Yeah.
How heavy would something like that weigh? So like the piece of rope that you had to remove, how much
is it? Well, this here shaft would probably weigh, with the pinions and everything, probably 700-800 pounds.
Oh my goodness. So that's a major job, even just lifting it in and out then.
What did you do with the other shaft? Did you put it in the engine
and
take it down?
No, we just rolled it off along the track. They had to come up with the motor car last night.
It wore a little bit.
Can the any of it be salvaged, or is it just the whole thing scrapped
out? No, we can, like, use your collars and stuff. But what you have to do, you have to heat them's all shrunk on there.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to heat these up with a torch and drive them off. And when you go put them back, you make your shaft, say, about 5,000-6,000 bigger than this piece here. Well, you lay that in the fire and heat that red hot, see, it expands out.
Mm-hmm.
Then you slide that back on that shaft and cool it, and it shrinks right on it.
Hmm. Okay.
Same way with these here pinions. Here, you heat really them red hot. Then you have to take rig up some kind of rig where you pick that thing up and get it slid back on there. Work, they showed you how it was done, and you just follow on through with the way it was done years ago.
How long have you been working on this?
I've worked here about 22 years.
22 years? Mm-hmm. You've got quite a bit of experience in
it. I started fooling around when I was about 14. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. When the shaft was broke, wasn't it? Was the original one here?
No, it wasn't original. It probably didn't do it. Well, I hate to race off, but I'm going to have to get this thing oiled up.
I think.
Getting ready to depart Bald Knob now.
On.
Trained to run forward for a little. never decided I was going to do this. I checked around. In fact, I told you. I know,
good rain. We're taking it. The 25th anniversary of the Cassinic Railroad.
Come on, Matt.
The last, the largest, in the B&O Museum.
Well, the ride is over in the rain. That's it for this year. Well, apparently the cars are stored up there at the end of the line. And there's the ruins of the mill again. Well, thanks for sitting through another railroad video. This one was longer, but I appreciate it. Time flies when you're having fun. Take one last look. I don't know when I'm coming back again, probably not for a while.